Hello everybody, I'm Ivan and in this video I will show my enclosure for Voron Switchwire. This is a do-it-yourself Core Exit 3D printer I presented in a previous video. It is designed by Voron and basically the difference is that it doesn't have lead screws. Everything moves with belts on a similar arrangement like Core XY printer. Before going in details for the enclosure, I would like to give my feedback on working daily with this printer for the last 2 months. So I had zero issues. I mean, it delivered consistent printing quality and I didn't maintain or replace anything so far. I highlight this because I see on Voron Discord some people are struggling to get the perfect print. There could be many reasons for this, but I think the most important component for the printing quality with this printer are the belts, not the linear rails. You can buy cheap linear rails, then clean and grease them and they will work fine, but you shouldn't compromise on the belt quality. So my advice is to get the best belts you can find in your location and then to play with the tightening. They should be quite tight, but not over tightened. Myself, I use the high temperature belts from Gates. They are rated up to 135 degrees and they are a bit stiffer than the normal Gates belts. And also they don't deform at high temperature, which is important when you are using an enclosure. So there is a link in the video description if you want to see what I'm using. The only modification I did to the printer was to add a tensioner for the y-axis. I think it's needed and I hope there will be a solution coming from Voron on the next update. Now about the enclosure. Voron provides the drawings to cut panels. Their reference design is very refined and uses 9 panels. Rear black ABS panels and front acrylic. The assembly uses 3M VHB tape and screws to the frame. The printable parts include print-in-place hinges, magnetic handles for the door and one big opening on the top for the filament, as well other elements to stick the panels with VHB tape. There are already many companies on the net selling the panels for around 100 euro. For my enclosure though, I decided to go in a different way and build it from clear policarbonate sheets. For me, the policarbonate has clear advantage over the acrylic because it's more strong material, high temperature resistant, non-flammable, and it has low thermal conductivity. So I think those qualities should improve the security and perform better to keep the temperature inside. Other advantage is you can cut it and drill it without cracking, almost like wood. And so I decided to cut my panels myself and save some money. So the total cost for me was only for the material around 30 euro for around around 1.5 square meters of 4 millimeters thick policarbonate sheet. I had other objective to simplify the design so I can remove and install the enclosure in order to gain access for maintenance works. I unified the side panels and the top panel, so I ended up having just 5 panels, rear, top, 2 side panels and the 2 doors. Anything else I kept more or less like in the reference design, so the panels are connected with 3M VHB tape, which is very solid and absorbs vibrations, and they are mounted to the frame with screws. Here you see the enclosure standalone to get better idea what it is. No complex shapes, all panels are rectangular and easy to cut at home. I tried to minimize all openings and clearances in order to better keep the heat inside. For example, instead of using large top opening for the filament, I have a single hole with bow filament guide, which works pretty well. I also enlarged the hinges to make them more solid with screws. On the enclosure door, I have a Raspberry Pi camera for supervising remotely the print job and for time lapses. For the points where the enclosure connects to the frame with screws, I printed kind of vibration dampers from TPU. Not sure it's needed because I didn't witness any sensible vibrations, but it doesn't hurt to have it, just in case. Being able to mount and remove the enclosure at once is important for me. And here you see how it is installed on the printer. I wouldn't refuse a helping hand, but it is manageable by one person also. I believe the removal should be easier than the mounting. Last, I fixed the magnetic door handles and the latch with instant glue. The magnets are covered with a thin layer of ABS slurry. It holds them in place and suppresses the annoying clicking noise when closing the doors. Now let's see what temperature could be reached in the enclosure. I will measure it with the hotend thermistor while the bed is heated to 110 degrees Celsius, which is the ABS hotbed temperature when using PEI sheet. For less than 10 minutes it established to 60 degrees Celsius, which is great for ABS and possibly for small policarbonate parts.
I will test the enclosure with one model I wanted to print in some time. It's a BB-8 case for Google Home Mini. This is a complex model consisting in more than 20 parts with different geometries and is perfect for the test. All parts will be printed with very basic and cheap ABS, with layer height of 0.3 mm for the large parts and 0.2 mm for the smaller ones, at maximum speeds of 40 to 60 mm per second depending on the part. I will use rafts because the dimensional accuracy is important for this model, and even a small warping will require to reprint the part. All ABS parts have printed successfully. I like working with ABS because of the post-processing options it gives. Although the layer resolution wasn't perfect for this model, 30 minutes in the acetone cloud made the part smooth as silk. For the painted parts, I used nail polish, which is for me the best and most durable paint for ABS. Now I will try to print the BB-8 stand from policarbonate. I print PC filament successfully on my other printer with heated chamber and AC heated bed, but here this bed can go safely to just 110 degrees long run, and I came with the following technique to assure bed adhesion. A raft from ABS or ideally from PC ABS, then at the last raft layer I load the policarbonate filament. It sticks well to the ABS and is easy to remove when cooled down. After changing the filament, the temperature is to be adjusted to 300 degrees Celsius for printing the policarbonate. My hotend can go above 400 degrees Celsius. Check the video description to see what I use. At the end of the print I had some warping on the raft ends, but the stand printed successfully. Since I printed other smaller solid policarbonate parts with the same technique, and it works quite well.
That's all from me. I hope this video is useful for people building an enclosure for Voron Switchwire. Thanks for watching and see you for my next project. Bye bye. Hey Goo, play BBC Radio 1.
I call BBC Radio 1 from the BBC.
I call it Goo. Unfortunately, I cannot use BB8 because Google doesn't allow to use a custom keyword. But if you... Okay, Goo. Stop it. But if you play with the settings a bit, you can eventually use Goo or Gook. Still better than repeating a company name all the day. I mean, I really hope Google will allow to use a custom keyword so I can call this one BB8. Hey BB8. Doesn't work. So, seriously, thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.